following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do a great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's a TGIF, folks. Let's make it a great one. Don't take anything personally. Transform your life. When you refuse to take things personally, you avoid many upsets in your life. Your feeling of anger, jealousy, and even sadness will simply disappear if you don't take it personally. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 34, NASDAQ down 40, S&P's off 4.5, gold contract flat, $12.29 an ounce, silver up 4 cents, $14.64 an ounce, light sweet crude up a half a buck, $69.20 a barrel. Notes and bonds, you get the 10-year note down 5 ticks, 117.31. 30-year bond down 10, 137.26. And King dollar down 200 ticks, trading 95.440. The euro is trading at 115.09 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is trading at 112.5 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, we get option expiration. You get a sideways market out here. Bottom line is that you come off these highs, have big volume on the way down. You popped up with light volume. And because it's option expiration, folks, it's going to be all about what is the volume out here today? What are we coming in with? Thus far, it looks to me that what we have is that you have it, we're going to come down, and I've seen this happen before, that you don't get volume inside the market, meaning even on option expiration. You get an expansion, but not a monster expansion. And if that's what we got, that is saying you're going to get a bounce in this market before we're going downtown. Okay, that's the bullish side. Well, it's really not a bullish side, because my take is that we're building a B to a C of a monster ABC down. But that would be saying that you're still going to get the bounce. Now, the other side of that, and this is what we're going to know, because it's all, we have the price. We know where the price is at, unless the thing's blast topside. We know where the price is at. The price is down. So if we have an expansion of volume, but you need a big one here, then different ball game. Then it would be like, okay, man, you're ready to go after the B point of this ABC structure on the way down. And we'll see where it shakes out, because, see, right now what you have is this. It doesn't look to me that you're going to have the volume, because we did $134 million yesterday in the SPY. That is going into the 274. What happens, folks, whether you're going down or going up, is markets lose their energy. And what has happened is that we came down really fast. You bounce for 3 or 4 days. You're coming right down again. Bottom line, sellers get tired. So we'll see how this shakes out coming into the close. That's on your SPY. NDX 100, 3Qs set up the same way. Difference in the 3Qs is that the 3Qs very well could get the volume going. We're at 63 million. They can put 20 million into the 3Qs coming into the close. We'll see if that's the case. That's 82 from yesterday, 143 from the downdraft. They're not going to put 143 in. But bottom line, we'll see what kind of an expansion we do get. Small caps. Small caps, folks, are the biggest downdraft. Still showing they're the weakest. The IWM basically coming down And let's see. Yeah, so yesterday we had 31 million. You're at 25. The IWM can do it. The IWM can have the volume, actually. And you're laying right at the lows. The close this week for the IWM was 154.17. And right now you're below that. We're at 153.15. We set this up. Yeah, the small caps, man. February 9th, folks, the small caps are going to go after us first. That February 9th, that you talk about sticking out like a sore thumb. I mean, this is pretty intense. February, the week of February 9th, the high of that is $153.79. The low is $142.50. It looks like we're going to close in the bar. You close in the bar, guess what? C'est la vie, baby. You're going there. And if that's the case, in the small caps, your probability is going to go actually a lot higher that we're going to get that in all the indices also. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold contract out here. Trading flat out here today. We had a movement from 1226 to 1234, laying at the highs. Gold broke topside about a week and a half ago. Goes from 1194 up to the 1230. Has volume behind the move. Gold wants to run up into this 1335 level. We go take a look at the note market. Okay, so now the note market is confirming also that this baby, meaning the market, wants lower price. They refuse, the notes and bonds folks refuse to back off. We're at 117.31. You're going into the strength. You've only had 1.8 million contracts today. That's light contract volume going into strength. The strength that we're going into is 3.6 million. So you're talking about big numbers out here. 30-year set up the same way. What do you have with the 30-year? 30-year is backing down with 349,000 contracts. And I think we're dealing with 700,000 or 800,000. Let's see. Yeah, 782,000. King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? Well, King Dollar, this is a situation that you actually were coming in with some decent volume, but guess what? Man can't handle it. You get a seller that's just laying there in King Dollar, and they're laying there right at that 95,800 mark. Did it again. Yeah, so we'll see where this baby shakes out. Each time that the dollar tries to get higher, bottom line, you have a sellers that are laying right there. Each time it tries to get lower, bottom line, you don't have any sellers there. You don't have any sellers pushing it below the 94 mark. So pretty wild in that whole context. Very tight trading range. Oil market. What do we have with oil? Oil market right now trading at a price point of $69.20. That oil market is making its way down into the $65 level. Last 2 weeks, we just went from the $76 level to 69. You're in the lower trading range. That puts game into the lower swing points, which are $63 to $64. So bottom line, looks to me that oil market wants to go south. That's great, of course, for gasoline. It's good for all you folks in the Northeast, the Midwest, anywhere it's going to be cold, because bottom line, oil pushing $75 is big, big numbers for heating. Dow Industrials right now up 45, Nasdaq's down 38, S&P's are off 3.5. We'll come right back. Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials up 36. You get the NASDAQ down 43. S&Ps are off 4. Let's go inside the NDX 100 and take a look at the strength versus the weakness. Strength out here, PayPal, folks. PayPal's up by 8.5%. You got Kraft Heinz up 3.4%. Taken away from it. eBay is taking a big hit. That's down 9.5%. NVIDIA's down 4%. You get Intuitive Surgical down 3.6%. And Netflix is down 3.6%. Let's start with NVIDIA. We go take a look at NVIDIA. NVIDIA, high flyer, no doubt. And these chip stocks, folks, are not only getting hammered. This is a big heads up for the deal about the NASDAQ and the NDX 100. So NVIDIA's basically blowing away a swing point. It's not going to have the volume. 3.2 million out here today. You have it has to be 5.5 to get an ABC structure on the way down. But NVIDIA's been on a straight line down from 229. It was trading 229 on the 2nd of October. So bottom line, bring this back, line it up, and what you're going to see, and we know where it's going, folks. It's going right after the high volume low, which it hasn't tested yet. That's only $204. Now, the thing that's amazing, right, no doubt, is that you get an equity that literally 15 trading days ago was at 292. And you're going to be at 204 probably next week. AMD, they're all doing this, by the way. Someone is unloading these things like hand over fist. If we go take a look at AMD, what you're going to see, AMD, this was another high flyer. Bottom line, does it finishes an ABC structure on the way up at $34. It's $10 off the high, like in a heartbeat. This also doesn't look like it's going to have the volume on the way down, breaking a B point. That being said, we take this, you put this back, and this looks like it's heading for the, let's see, so we broke down 24. Well, it has to break 24 first. Coming into the 24, it looks to me like this thing probably wants to get back into $17, which would be a mind blower. That'd be like getting cut in half in about a heartbeat. Lam Research, LRCX. Let's take a look at one of Lam Research. Lam's just flat out here today. Lam's already down from 209, you're trading 146. Big numbers. The XLE, let's go take a look at the oil equities, XLE out here. Now XLE, you know, you're down 56 cents, but XLE is gonna need more volume to really break down. You know, it broke down really well last week. There's no doubt. We went from 78 bucks to where it's 71. That being said, it's going into the top of the high volume low that's laying out here from February 9th. So most times when you do that, bottom line, you have to build cause for a bit. We'll see if that's the case. And what you can get out of this, if you don't build cause, folks, and you go right into that bar and you dig deep into it like 2 or 3 points, get out of the way, man, because then it's showing how fast and furious the market actually is and how weak the market actually is. We're going to take a look at the banks, the XLF. XLF out here. We take a look at the, that can't hold price. That's up 12 cents. And this is the reason that the XLF is a big number and that you want to pay attention to it is the banks came out with numbers, folks, and the numbers were great. Bottom line, numbers were great. And what do? They sell it off. JP Morgan, you know, made money hand over fist. Well, JP Morgan just came down from 119, you're at 108. Netflix is another one. Netflix is a heads up in general for the fangs. And the reason that it's such a heads up is that what you had is this. So picture, two different things happened with Netflix. What you didn't do is you didn't even get to the swing point. That's a big number. You got into the downdraft that had been created out here in the last earnings call, which was on the 16th of July. Then when we take this and you put this up on a larger time frame, well, bottom line is that you came off the highs, you came down with monster volume from 403 to 344. You did that in July. You didn't make the swing point. This is a big number because now what this is, this whole week in Netflix, this is jamming lower with volume. That's a huge problem. So we'll see where the baby wants to go. It looks to me like it's going to go to 274. Right now you're at 333. We put this on a monthly. Monthly it looks worse. Monthly, man, it can take a hit and a half. Let's go over to Amazon, take a look at Amazon. So Amazon right now. Okay, so Amazon's trading $1,760. Hey, this is going to be wild, folks, watching this shakeout next week. Because the way, like, Amazon is trading right now, this looks to me that it is on the way to its B point, and it could be a monster ABC down. And your A on this is 2,033. Your B is 1685. Did I say 2,033? Holy cow. Oh my God. Okay, so that's 345 points. Man, that'd get you into like the 1410 area. Yep. Yeah, let me bring this down. Well, do we know what's gonna stick out here? Unreal. 14. There it is, man. Now that's the April low. It's not even the February. That's the April. Yeah, 1415 is the April low. And you still have the February low laying out here. And the high of the February low is 1416. Well, 1416 may be a place that could slow it down, but that's going to be quite a hit. If we pull this back just a little bit more, I'm just curious of what kind of a, yeah, see, Amazon was such a expansion on the way up that if I took it from the, right from the last trend, yeah, that makes sense. $1,257 from a high to a low, bottom line, not a big deal. Pretty amazing, actually. It's pretty crazy. Last night, folks, I did a workshop for my gold subscribers. You can check it out right now. You can be a gold subscriber. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. The way you do that, you come over to our website at TFNN. You hit Gold Report. You can subscribe for 1 month, 6 months, or a year. They all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, and if you do that ASAP, what you're going to see is that you're not going to be into the gold report. You're going to have that workshop that I did last night for the subscribers right on your page. You can go over it over the weekend. So check it out at the front page of TFNN. If we go into that gold market and take a look at it right now, we take a look at the XAU, the HUI. What we do have inside the XAU and the HUI, they both broke topside last week. had volume behind the move. We're going into the downdraft bar out here of the week of the 17th. And bottom line, folks, you broke the downdraft and downtrend that had been going on since April, and you did break that with conviction. So when you get a break with conviction, bottom line with that saying is that we are going to go to the top of that range. Real question is going to be, how fast do we get there? And the wild card is going to be the U.S. dollar. The U.S. dollar is still in this trading range, tight range. Bottom line, it's going to break. The real question is which way it's going to break. The bonds want to go higher, so that's telling me that the dollar wants to go lower. Stay right there, folks. We've got our man, Mr. Dave White, coming back with us. We're going to be talking technology. Dow Industrials right now up 101. NASDAQ is down 25. S&Ps are up 2. We'll come right back.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Hi folks, this is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 106. You get the NASDAQ down 19. S&P's up 4. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Dave White, as we do each and every Friday at 30 past the hour. Don't forget, folks, Dave does an outstanding show every trading day right here. 2 to 3 Eastern Standard Time. Also has 2 great newsletters. He has the Tech Insider as well as the Path of Least Resistance. You can check out both of them. Both come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Just go to TFNN.com, go under newsletters, check it out. Dave White, what's going on?
Well, we had an IPO that kind of snuck out the door today.
Okay. SolarWinds, huh?
Yeah, SWI is the symbol on it. This was one they've been trying to push out for a while. I was kind of surprised that they got it out at all. They raised $375 million today, but it was going to be like a $600 million one at the beginning.
Okay.
Finally pushed it out. So you probably want to watch it for a while. This is one that I don't think it makes a lot of sense for them to be public at the moment.
What do they do?
They make what?
What do they do?
They make a lot of software to control your cloud services.
It's so funny they call it SolarWinds, man. Some of these names I don't get, man. It's wild.
And it sounded, I always thought it was, at the beginning, was some kind of solar cell
exactly.
thing, right?
Right.
Yeah. Anyway, they've been, I guess they actually had the name since 1998. So it's not new.
Okay.
Been around for a while, 20 years or so. Austin-based company. But my problem with it is the same problem I see with a lot of other companies that are trying to do this, and that is more and more as everybody goes to cloud-based services at the big guys like Google and Amazon and Microsoft, they don't have that many people to sell to because those guys have all their own stuff or they hire their own people
sure.
to write exactly what they need for what their own stuff. But they got it out the door anyway. I'll keep an eye on it, but I'm trying to figure out the case where this thing actually, you know, goes up 500% in the next few years or 10 years with cloud services. And that, unless there's a big change in what people are doing for antitrust, it's hard. And in fact, even on that part, there's four big companies, so they're probably not going to be antitrust on the cloud services business. So I don't really know.
There's no way in the cloud services because you got Google that won't deal with the government, and then you got Amazon who's the government's child. So, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But there's plenty of them there, right? It's hard to make the case
right.
that there's only one or two companies.
Right, right.
There's a lot of companies, and they just get bigger and have a larger economy to scale every day. There may be enough business for SolarWinds, but I don't see the idea where these guys ever become, you know, stock goes from whatever it is, $15 today
sure.
to 100. It seems awful tough. But just my thoughts on that. There weren't a lot of new tech IPOs out last 4 weeks of any kind of note. But
It's always tough when you get a down market to push an IPO out. That's for sure.
Well, that's one thing. But why do you push a IPO out in a bad market? If it's a good IPO, you just wait.
Because they thought it could get worse.
yeah. That's
it's called the window opening and the window closing, folks. And it is amazing. You know, folks, you can even get a great company, and if the IPO window closes, it closes. And specifically what it means is that on a down market, they can't sell anything. It's just it's that cut and dry deal, man.
Everybody's raising cash. They're not spending.
No way.
Well, I heard you talking about NVIDIA.
Yes.
Earlier, and one of the things that is kind of interesting over the last 10 days is the amount of used video cards coming on the market on eBay. You talked about NVIDIA down.
Yes, yeah.
Also AMD.
Right.
Apparently, there are a lot of companies in the Bitcoin mining business
okay.
that have gone belly up, and now all the stuff that they spent you know, 100 or 200 bucks over retail
okay.
to buy
yeah.
is now hitting it. Now, normally, 3-4 months ago, you would have seen 200 or 300 cards on eBay.
I see.
Used. And now they've got about 5,000.
Wow.
And apparently
that's intense.
This is hitting some kind of record this week on eBay. So if you want to buy a video card, apparently there are a ton of them to buy. But I didn't hear about it. But apparently, a lot of these Bitcoin companies that decided to go big into the big move up to $20,000 have now gone belly up and bankrupt. And these things are now hitting, you know, these guys would buy 100 or 200 of these things.
Yeah, like nothing,
at
right?
a location.
Right.
So there's a lot of these out there.
Wow.
And again, like I said, you know, one of the reasons why.
And these would be better cards, too, right?
They're kind of not the absolute best, but probably
close
an 8 on a 10
okay,
of whatever
cool. right.
the one is. But they are available and they are cheap. in comparison to what the new cards are. But of course, that means with used equipment out there that both AMD and NVIDIA are probably going to see light sales until that goes, that those cards go away and find a home. It's always going to kind of keep a lid on it. And of course, that means companies like Micron that supply the VRAM for those cards also have an issue. And when we look at the SMHs today, yeah, they're kind of hovering around down at those lows. And I guess I'm probably going to wait for Monday to make a determination, but it looks like SMHs.
Yeah, and you know what's happening? Just since when I brought up AMD, I thought it would never have the volume, man. Well, the volume is coming in, man. Like, it's like that. Well, we might be breaking this B point with volume. When I first said this, folks, okay, 10 minutes ago, we're at 93 million. Now it's got 115 million AMD on the way down.
I was going to tell you that of the Bitcoin mining cards, 3/4 of them are AMDs.
Wow. Okay. Yeah.
They got that huge part of the market. Only about 1/4 of it was NVIDIA. NVIDIA really was going after the machine learning part of the business because they thought it would last longer.
Yeah.
But even that's kind of a little soft right now. So my guess is you're going to see a lot more downside on AMD than you probably will see on NVIDIA, although NVIDIA's had a great deal already.
But pretty wild.
They're really going to get hurt probably a lot more about it. And you always wonder whether or not this isn't a sign that maybe there is some kind of low coming in Bitcoins. You know, you get rid of a lot of those guys.
Oh, no, that's a great point, man. Listen, you know, Bitcoin's been popping around the lows, folks, of the 6,300 and been dead as a dog. You know?
And you got to love that if you're a trader, right?
Right, right.
Exactly. Everybody's forgotten about it.
Yep.
The cards are being sold.
Yep.
You get a few miners out of the business, and maybe there's enough money to get back into it.
But so there's a few articles that are claiming that it costs more than what Bitcoin's trading for right now just to mint the Bitcoin. You know?
Right. It's about $8,000 right now.
Yeah. So.
So. And that's if you're in a country with a low electrical rates, much less, you know, it can be as much as 10,000.
Hydropower, yeah, you need the hydropower, right.
Yeah, you need cheap electricity. But we're almost getting ready to go to break. But anyway, looking at that, I'm just thinking that we're probably looking at a soft Christmas in the video card business where generally this is their best quarter.
Oh, interesting, okay.
They're probably still going to be selling, NVIDIA's got new cards that are the smoking hottest for video games. But again, I don't know if a lot of people are going to be using it. We'll talk about more when we come back.
Stay right there, folks. Dave and I are coming right back. We have the Dow up 117. NASDAQ is down 18. S&Ps are down 3.5. Up 3.5. Coming right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. I've talked with our man, Mr. Dave White. We are coming into the close at option expiration, and it'll be interesting to see what kind of juice they can get in this market, folks. Thus far, there's not a lot of volume, so we'll see where this shakes out. Okay, we're looking at Nobel Physics, Nobel Prize, right?
Yeah. Of course, one of the ones down at the bottom, I'll start with it because it's the shorter one of the two. Everybody knows that LASIK, those ads you can get
your eyes fixed
forever. Well, the two folks from, one was from France, one's from Canada, got one half of that Nobel Prize. These are all about lasers.
Okay.
But their part was the ultra-short optical pulses that were basically later used to make LASIK and some of the other
stuff. That's so cool, man. That changes people's lives. Yeah, that's awesome.
But the other one, that's been around for a while. The other one really has my interest is this other one from a guy named Arthur Ashkin. He made optical tweezers where he can move individual cells of bacteria around without touching them. They actually had the first picture of a atom taken with a literal photographic system that we're kind of used to.
Okay.
And actually could hold the single atom in space.
Wow.
And you could take a picture of it. These optical, what they call optical tweezers, are just ways of moving things around using laser beams, are really coming on with a lot of new technology that's going to be around for a while.
That's a whole
different... probably make a lot of money.
Yeah, that's a whole different ballgame. I mean, what you're talking about, folks, the thing that's so cool about atoms in general is that, you know, it's hard to even comprehend what they are and how they work. It's more bizarre that you're saying that now we'll get a pair of optical tweezers, we can start moving them around. Because then I think you can understand them more, right?
Right. But one of the big breakthroughs that's come from this is the ability to go into blood and move cells that have like leukemia.
Okay.
And just pick them out and just move them over. Move them in and out of the blood. So
that's
you can
phenomenal.
Literally figure on a cell by cell basis and say, okay, this one's cancerous.
Yeah,
this one's not.
Wow.
But you can do that from everything. And of course, it didn't have it in the article, but I knew from reading stuff in the past. You can use lasers. Everybody thinks you cut, you know, steel with lasers and it's heat and all that. One of the things that most people don't know is that you can actually make things cold with lasers.
Okay.
And a great deal of what's going to be happening in the future for superconductors are all going to be about lasers. And that is literally cooling everything down to nothing. Now, optical tweezers are kind of the same technology that this guy developed and got the Nobel Prize for. But atoms, when they just kind of move back and forth, they're always moving back and forth. If you can quit them, make them move, then the temperature will drop down to almost nothing. And you can start making things like quantum computers and doing other things, actually get an eye on them, because almost all of them are moving. In fact, even if you get down to zero, the atoms are always moving just a little bit anyway. They're always going to be kind of just bouncing around like a kid that had too much sugar.
Because that's what they do anyway, right? Yeah,
but I mean, you would think that if you finally get to, you can't get any colder, that it would stop.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And it doesn't. But with lasers, you can bring them down to almost to the absolute theoretical low of zero Kelvin. But it is kind of interesting that we are seeing these Nobel Prize. I think the guy, Ashkin, I think his is like 10 years old. But the people that did the
LASIK, that's been around
like 25 or 30 years old.
Right.
I think I'd want to have that money a lot sooner in my life than later.
That's
but
for
probably
sure.
Better late than never.
That's
hey,
for sure.
I didn't think about it, but $1 billion for tonight.
Yeah, $1 billion, folks, is the in you know, Tommy just got me in a pool. I don't even know how it works, but I know there's so many states involved in it, right? It's $1 billion, folks, with one B. Yeah.
Right.
Pretty intense, man. Someone's gonna win it. Might as well be us.
Well, if I don't see you Monday, I don't know what happened.
Seriously, man. Oh my God, that's pretty. It's pretty amazing when you think $1 billion. I remember folks when they were fighting about whether they wanted lotteries in, and then as soon as they got the lotteries in, of course, the politicians had a field day because guess what? It was supposed to do wonders for the schools. Well, they figured out how else to basically spend it outside of getting people educated. But sad but true. But anyway, Google unbundled. Oh yeah, let's talk about this, man. I was reading about this, man.
Yep, Google will have to sell Android without anything installed, like YouTube or all the other, you know, their Mail Pro. And it's not a big deal, because if you buy one of these phones, you can always just install it off the App Store anyway. So it's not like, I don't know if it's that big a deal, but it does kind of conjure up the issues that we saw around Windows Internet Explorer and Microsoft in 98 that went through 2001 that really almost broke the company up. But all these companies now, the next level in the EU is, and Facebook too, is if they do anything more, the next fine isn't just going to be $1 billion. It's going to be 4% of their net revenues. So they are moving up the fines that are going to be in levied if these guys continue to break at least the rules over there in Europe. Facebook, I think, already has. They're talking about that 4% coming in the next couple of months. I think that's working through the EU at the moment, why everybody's kind of thinking about Brexit and everything. But it does look like that 4%. I don't know what that would do to a big company like, I mean, it's a lot of money, but I don't know what it would do to a big company like Facebook or Google. Is 4% enough to hurt the stock price?
The way I look at the Facebook and Googles is like, you can fine them quite a bit of money, because think about how much they fine the banks. They just make it part of their business model, man. I mean,
right,
the banks have paid more money than anything. And
yeah, but that's an individual fine. This is 4% of every day's net, every day's gross dollar amount.
Yeah, my understanding is that, you know, and that's right, I'm sure it could hurt them, but I was reading an article that, yeah, they might have did that there, but people are going bonkers, and they want the search on their phones, and they want Chrome, so it's going to be interesting to see how this thing shakes out, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
they're going to start charging them. That's what it said. They're going to start charging them, so we'll see where it shakes out, man. Yeah.
Well, I'm just wondering, is 4% of the net revenues, that's like doing 96% of what you're doing. And I guess it's Europe, so probably what, one third of, maybe one fourth of what they make?
Well, watch what you do, though. You take 4%, then you could write the 4% off because that's a fine. So now you, right? And that's just a fine.
They're already screaming that they're not paying taxes already.
Yeah, right. Well, they're not going to pay any more taxes. Stay right there, folks. Dave and I come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Talking with our man, Mr. Dave White. We're talking technology, and this one's a sad one, no doubt. So, Paul Allen. Well,
yeah, one of the co-founders of Microsoft passed away this week. 65 years old.
I know, man. Course, so young. My God.
Yeah, but you think about it. His life started at, 17 with starting his own company.
Yes.
Within 2 years of being in college, everybody had quit.
Yeah.
And started Microsoft and started moving along, and they're probably much better off for it. But one of the things I thought about is that there are people that understand how to program. But as far as CEOs now, this is kind of, you got in Apple, you had Woz.
Yeah.
But he was gone fairly quickly at Apple. He hadn't worked there since 86 or whatever. But for any real things. But there weren't a lot of people now that really grew up in that period and understood from the ground up. From programming and assembler languages, all the way to how the hardware works, and could actually do anything themselves.
Right.
At the base level, he's kind of like the last guy to go. You still have Bill Gates.
Sure.
But there aren't that many people, you know, that it's kind of...
That knows all the moving parts, right? That's what you're saying. Yeah, right.
He was kind of one of the few guys. A lot of people, you always hear about Bill Gates. You almost never hear about Paul Allen. Probably because he spent the last 10 years on a billion-dollar...
Yeah. Well, he retired at 30. I read the story. Unfortunately, folks, he got cancer at 30. And then he realized he could die any second. And then he beat that. Then he got lymphoma. Then he beat that. And then it came back with the vengeance, man. You know? So, yeah.
Yeah.
Unreal.
But he's found all kinds of stuff. We're going to see, I think it's either later this fall or next year. You'll see a lot of... documentaries of what he's found on his big billion-dollar yacht that he's been cruising around the Pacific for. He found a bunch of World War II ships that were sunk, some other stuff.
Cooking, brother. Thanks so much, Dave. Folks, have a great weekend, safe weekend. We look forward to speaking right back here Monday morning, 8:30. Join Jason. Go get him, folks.
Jason Path has just launched his weekly newsletter, The Quantitative Edge, available only at TFNN.com. Right now, you can sign up for Jason's outstanding weekly report, including midweek updates whenever warranted, with a 30-day money-back guarantee included, so you have nothing to risk. Jason develops his trade recommendations by creating an ensemble of predictive and mathematical models trained on data by leveraging a variety of techniques, including market-based computer simulations. Jason then combines these sophisticated predictive and analytical models with deeply researched macro outlooks to identify opportunities in a number of different markets for traders to act on. Whether you're looking to trade futures, equities, commodities like crude oil and gold, Forex, or cryptos, Jason covers it all. Sign up for Jason Paff's weekly trading newsletter right now by visiting the front page of TFNN.com, and you'll find the Quantitative Edge under the Newsletters tab. TFNN.com, educating investors.